Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we will try to understand 4-bit parallel adder cum subtractor. In our previous class, we have clearly seen 4-bit parallel adder. So it is also called as ripple carry adder. This is also a ripple carry adder. But the difference between that adder and this one is, here we can do both the addition and subtraction on a single combinational circuit. This is the circuit for both the adder cum subtractor. So for example, if you have two numbers, so if you want to add these two and if you want to subtract these two, so the addition and the subtraction can also be done on this single circuit. So how that is done, we will try to understand. Before that, we will try to do the addition and subtraction of these two binary numbers. So the decimal representation of these binary numbers is 11 and 9. So we are going to add both these two. So addition is direct, is directly done. Okay, it is 001101. This is 01, and this is 1, and this is 01. So the addition of it is 20. Okay, so now if you try to subtract this, so how to subtract signed numbers? So the signed number subtraction has been clearly explained in our previous videos. In the discussion about number system, the subtraction of signed numbers has been clearly explained. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. And the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Now, how to do this? First, this signed number has to be converted into 2's complement. So, how to do the 2's complement? 2's complement is 2's complement. First, do the 1's complement. The 1's complement of it is 0110 and add 1 to it. So, this is the given number. We have converted it into 1's complement, and adding 1 to it is going to give the 2's complement. So the 2's complement of this number 1001 is 011. Okay, so now we have to, so after obtaining the 2's complement, we have to add that number that has been obtained by the 2's complement to the given number. So these two numbers are to be added. Okay, if you add this, it is going to be 01011101. So this 1 will get eliminated. So the discussion about these concepts has been clearly made, and the final result is going to be, we have to check for the MSB. MSB is 0, so the number obtained is a positive number and its value is 2. So the decimal equivalent of this number is 2. So 11 minus 9 is 2. So how these calculations are done on the combinational circuit? The only difference between, so the previous adder circuit and this circuit, so the only difference between these two circuits is we have added an extra variable called M, and we have added an extra XOR gate to the every bit of the B. So for every bit of this number, so an extra XOR gate is added, and one of the input is directly given to this XOR. So the digit for B0, B1, B2, B3 is directly given to this XOR, and the other input is this M. So what this M consists of? If you try to do addition, this M is provided with 0. It is a 1-bit variable. So if you try to do an addition, it is provided with 0. So how to do the addition? So these are the corresponding values of the variables A0, B0, A1, B1, A2, B2 and A3, B3. So directly given. So if, so on what logic does this M works is, the use of this M is, if we try to add, we are going to give this M with 0. If you try to subtract, so if you want to do subtraction, so it has to be provided with 1. So what happens with this is, so this M is provided as a input for C0. If the subtraction is given, means this M is provided as an input. So the value of M, 1 is provided as an input to this carry C0. And if it is addition, the value 0 is provided as an input to this carry. What happens with this logic of this XOR gate is, XOR gate is, so see here, for consider only that B naught, B XOR 0. What happens if the if you try to find the B XOR 0, this is equal to B. So for example, if the value of B is 0, 0 XOR 0 is equal to 0, 1 XOR 0 is equal to 1. So what, on what value does this operation depends? So this value is equal to B. B XOR 0 is equal to B. So we are providing 0 to this XOR gate if you are trying to do addition. If 0 is provided as one of the input to the XOR gate, the value of the B will be represented as it is. Okay. So if we try to do subtraction, so this 1 will get provided. So at the value of M, 1 will get provided. What happens with this 1? So one of the what happens with this 1 is B XOR 1. What is this B XOR 1? So if the value of B is 0, 0 XOR 1 is 1. So the value of B is 0, the output is 1. Okay. If the value of B is 1, 1 XOR 1 is 0. So here B is 0 and it is providing an output of 0. So the complement of B is obtained. So B XOR 1 is going to produce the B's complement. So that's why 1 is provided whenever we try to do the subtraction. Why we have to do is, we have to do the 2's complement. In order to do the complement of B, we are provided with this XOR gate. So that is the logic behind this combinational circuit. That is the only difference between the adder and the subtractor. Whenever we try to do subtraction, M is provided with 1. Whenever 1 is provided, so as one of the input of the XOR gate, it is going to generate the complement of B. Similarly, whenever we try to add the numbers, whenever we try to add these numbers, the M is provided with 0. So whenever 0 is provided as the input, one of the input of XOR gate, it is going to produce the exact value of B. So in order to do the 2's complement, whenever we try to do the subtraction, in order to do the 2's complement, in order to generate the complement, 1's complement of the 2's complement, in order to provide the complement of this number, we are using this XOR gate. And this 1 is provided as the input. So this is extra 1. So why this M is connected to this input C0 is, whenever 1 is provided, we are trying to add 1 to this number. Okay. So let's find this. This 1 is equal to 0. If you try to subtract, what happens? So this one will get complemented to 0. This B1 value will get complemented to 1. And this B2 will get complemented to 1. And this B3 will get complemented to 0. So what we have obtained at the end of this XOR gate, it is 0, 1, 1, 0. So the complement of 1, 0, 0, 1 is 0, 1, 1, 0. So it has been obtained. Now what we have to do in order to get the 2's complement is, we have to add 1. So this 1 has to be added. So in order to do that, so this 1 has to be added. So in order to make that, this M will be provided as the input C0 value. So the N as an input to the least significant full adder. So this is how the 2's complement of the given number will be done, and the addition of these two is going to provide the subtraction value. So the full adder is capable of adding 3 bits. So we are going to add these 3 bits. What are those 3 bits? It is 0, 1, 1. So what we have done here also, okay. So what we have done here, it is provided as, so we are going to add these two. So here the B naught is, okay. So so the complete is done. So the complete addition is done. So it is 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 to this 1 is added. So this calculation is done. So we are going to get the subtraction value of the 2's complement. Okay, so the both these numbers will get subtracted and also get added. So this is the circuit for 4-bit parallel adder cum subtractor. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.